So when we consider the principle of seeking perfection, I think first of all we find ourselves up against a general problem, and that is that there are, in the field of continuous improvement, for example, there are many upsetting ideas. There are many ideas that challenge conventional practice, and our conventional education, our conventional wisdom. And there's a great temptation to pick and choose among them. This can be seen very clearly if one considers the ideas that and the practices that have been recommended to us by our teachers, that we will choose the ones that we're most comfortable with and we'll tend to ignore the other ones. We often use words that sort of directly contradict the notion that we even can seek perfection or that seeking perfection is the right thing. So for example, we have I think the very common experience of experienced people telling us that it's important to set achievable goals. The word achievable sneaks in. Or that we have to make reasonable demands, that we need to be achievable. We need to orient ourselves towards what's achievable, towards what's rational. When we make decisions, we often make decisions on what's possible. And this is entirely antithetical to what Dr. Shingo and his students have taught us over the years, that in fact, seeking perfection, seeking the radical, is extraordinarily powerful and actually necessary for fundamental change. So already we've made the task a little bit easier for ourselves. We don't have to be God. All we have to do is accept the notion that we can achieve zero defects. Well, even that's a stretch for most of us in business. We assume that there will always be defects. We assume that one of the reasons that there will always be defects is that our processes are run by human beings and that human beings are fallible and we make mistakes. Dr. Shingo's approach was quite different, and it was deeply humanistic in a way, because he identified our humanity. He identified mistakes and errors, inadvertent errors in particular, as being an essential part of our humanity. What he points out to us again and again is that a mistake is different from a defect. And this is a point that we often miss. And so that the idea is to excuse us our fallibility, our tendency to make mistakes, but to stop that mistake from turning into a defect.